Okay, so
ओके ओके
we'll be begin.
सर
Okay, so the topic that we are going to discuss is the animal tissue culture. So in simple way, animal tissue culture means the culture of the animal tissues in vitro. It's also called in vitro culture of the cells. So what is tissue culture? Okay, so we'll just define this one by one. So it is the in vitro culture of, in vitro means the anything which is done outside the body, that is called in vitro. So the word vitro means vitreous. It comes from the word vitreous, that means glass. That means anything which is done in the glass or anything which is done outside the body. If it is done inside the body, it is called in vivo. So it is in vitro culture of whole organs, okay, or tissue fragments or cells. That means tissue culture means, let me use the pen. Okay, so in tissue culture means it is the in vitro culture of either whole organs or tissue fragments or dispersed cells. Okay, so that is called tissue culture. Okay,
sir.
So now on a suitable nutrient medium. So in vitro culture of organ, whole organ or tissue fragments. Fragment means just we have taken some tissues and we have made some pieces of the tissues. And it's called tissue fragments. Okay, or dispersed cells. Dispersed cells means you have a cells which are dispersed. Okay, on a suitable nutrient medium and optimal culture conditions. So that means nutrient medium means because the in vitro, if we are growing the cells in vitro, so they need some nutrients. Okay, so wherever we will grow these cells, so these cells should be provided with some nutrients. So that in vitro nutrients used by the in vitro culture, it is called nutrient medium. Okay, and optimal culture condition. Optimal culture condition means most of the cells, they require 37 degree Celsius temperature. Okay, and they require the pH of around, say, 7 to 7.2. Okay, so this is the culture condition, temperature 37 degree and the pH of 7 to 7.2. okay, that is called culture condition. Okay, so under these conditions, you will have to provide these conditions to grow the cells in vitro. So the next, now we discuss about the classification of tissue culture. How do we classify different types of tissue culture? So tissue culture can be broadly divided into cell culture or organ culture. Okay, so now the cell culture means here we are using the dispersed cells. Okay, so so here this is basically using the dispersed cells. Okay, and there are two types. One is the monolayer and another one is the suspension. We'll discuss about it. Then the next is the organ culture. So organ culture, it is of two types. Let me move this. So one is the organotypic culture and histotypic culture. So organotypic culture means when you culture the organ in vitro, so it maintains the structure of the organ. Okay, but in case of histotypic culture, in this case what happens, the actual structure of the organ is distorted. It is not similar to the original organ. For example, if I use the whiteboard, say for example, if you have a say this is a particular organ present in vivo. Okay, fine. Now the same organ, if you are culturing in vitro in a petri plate, okay, so it is maintaining the same structure. Okay, so this is called organotypic culture, in which the structure of the organ remains the same. Okay, now what is histotypic culture? So in the histotypic culture, what happens? The organ does not retain its actual structure. So in this case, what's going to happen is this is the petri plate and so in this case, what has happened? The actual structure of the organ has altered. Okay, so this is called histotypic culture. That means the cells which are making this organ, they are same, but overall structure is different. That is called histotypic culture. Okay, am I clear?
Yes, sir.
Am I clear?
Yes, sir.
Okay, fine. So then, next we go for the, now this is the second type of classification. So tissue culture can be divided into two. One is called primary tissue culture, one is called cell lines. Okay, so primary tissue culture, these are the differentiated cells. That means these cells, they will not undergo many divisions. So they will undergo only 30 to 50 cell divisions. Cell lines, these are infinite cell divisions. That means these cells, they will go on dividing. That means what it means is that so this is the petri plate, and we are here, what we are doing, we are growing the cells. Okay, so yes, then once you put the cells over here, so these cells, what they will do, so these cells, they are growing in the petri plate. The petri plate contains the medium. So then what will happen? These cells will divide and then they will increase in the numbers. So then they will just simply increase their numbers. So now, thus in this case, if the cells are differentiated cells, that means if we are using the differentiated cells, so in this case, these cells will divide only for 30 to 50 cell divisions. That means, what does it mean? It means that one cell, okay, it will divide to only 30 or 50. That means one cell will not give rise to more than 50 cells. So one cell will not give rise to more than 50 cells. Okay?
Cells.
Yes, clear?
Sir. Yes, sir.
Okay. So this kind of tissue culture, so this is called primary cell culture.
Okay. Sir, but if it goes more than 50, then it won't...
No, these cells, after giving 50 numbers of daughter cells, these cells will die.
Oh.
They will not survive. okay,
yes sir.
and these cells, and these are the cells, these cells are obtained from a normal tissue.
Normally.
Say, for example, if you take the skin cells from an individual,
okay.
If you are taking the skin cell from an individual and you put it into the petri plate, so these skin cells will divide only 30 to 50 times only.
Oh.
After that, they will stop dividing and they will die.
Okay.
So this is what you see in case of primary cell culture. Now, what happens in case of cell line? So in case of cell line, so in case of cell line, what happens? Here, so here what happens, the cells which are used in this case, these are mainly the cancerous cells, because cancerous cells can continue dividing. So that means what you have done is that so let us say this is these are the cancerous cells, okay, in a individual. From this individual, these cancerous cells, they are put into the tissue culture plate, okay?
Yes, sir.
Fine. Now,
yes, sir.
what is going to happen is that these cells, they will start dividing, okay? So,
okay.
And these cells will start dividing, okay? And then they will just continue dividing. They will go on dividing. Okay.
Dividing.
So in case of primary cell culture, where we are using the differentiated cells, okay? So differentiated cells with skin cell, whatever somatic cells we have, all of these are differentiated cells. So these cells, if we grow in vitro, they will divide only for 20 to 30 or sorry, 30 to 50 times. Then thereafter, they will stop dividing. But the cancerous cells, they will not stop dividing. They will continue dividing. Okay. So that is why they are called continuous cell line. So they will go on dividing. Okay. So now what type of cells can divide continuously in the cell culture? So these cells are cancerous cells. Those cancerous cells, they will just go on dividing. Number two type of cell is the stem cells. Number three is the, we call it embryonic stem cells. So we call it adult stem cells. Okay. So cancerous cells, adult stem cells or embryonic stem cells, they can divide continuously. So these cells can be used, if we use them, so we don't have to worry that after some time they will die. They will not die. They will just go on multiplying till you have a very good medium. Okay. So that is what is the cell line and
cell.
Okay. Now we discuss about the transformation of a cell culture. So what do you mean by transformation? So here there are two things here. You have already studied about transformation. So earlier you have studied that what is transformation. So transformation, it is
transfer of DNA, sir.
Yeah, it is the transfer of DNA into a
recipient cell,
bacterial
recipient
cell, or recipient bacterial cell.
Material cell. सर
बैक्टीरियल सेल. नाउ दैट डेफिनेशन वॉज फॉर बैक्टीरिया, बट नाउ वी आर नॉट टॉकिंग अबाउट बैक्टीरिया, वी आर टॉकिंग अबाउट द टिश्यू कल्चर. सो इन केस ऑफ टिश्यू कल्चर द ट्रांसफॉर्मेशन हैज गॉट डिफरेंट मीनिंग. सो वॉट इज दैट मीनिंग? ऑल्टरेशन इन ए सेल कल्चर. ट्रांसफॉर्मेशन मीन्स ऑल्टरेशन इन ए सेल कल्चर दैट gives rise to continuous cell line. Okay, that means what it means is that in case of tissue culture, it means that the primary cell culture are converted to continuous cell line. So you know that in primary cell culture, the differentiated cells do not divide many times in vitro. That means, if I just make a diagram here, say for example, this, oh, sorry. This is the cell we have. Okay. Now, this particular cell is a differentiated cell. Okay. Now, this cell, if we go for cell culture, so now this particular cell, it will remain in the cell culture only for 20 to 50, sorry, not 20, it's 30. 30 to 50 cell division. Okay. And thereafter, what will happen? These cells, they will die. Okay, fine. Now, what is transformation here? In this case, what happens? So, this cell, it is transformed now what happens after transformation, this cell, it will divide continuously. Okay, fine. That means what it means is that, because we have seen that the only the cell line, that means the cells in the cell line, they only divide continuously. Differentiated cell cannot divide continuously. So what is done is that the differentiated cells, okay, they are made cancerous. Okay, fine. So then the cancerous cell will divide continuously. Okay, so that means if I summarize this, so this is a normal cell. Okay, it's a normal cell. Now this normal cell, it is made cancerous. Now the normal cell has become cancerous. Okay. Fine. Now once it becomes cancerous, so now this cancerous cell can be grown in vitro for a very infinite period, for a long period. That means the cell will not die. Okay. Fine. So this process, it is called transformation. So in case of cell culture, transformation means conversion of a normal differentiated cells into a cancerous cell. Okay. That will allow the cell to remain in culture for a prolonged period. That means it will go on dividing. It will not stop. It will help in formation of the continuous cell line. So process is called transformation.
So the process, it will go on in vitro or sir, in vivo, sir?
This is in vitro. See, we take out the cell, okay? Yes. Then yes, perform the transformation. Now your normal cell becomes cancerous cell. And yes, then yes, oh, this cancerous cell, you put it into the culture. So it will divide continuously. Okay? Yes. Fine.
Yes, sir.
That is called transformation. Yes. So that means, in nutshell, the differentiated cell, a differentiated cell means they cannot divide, they cannot divide more than 50 times. Okay, a differentiated cell, it is made continuously dividing cell. Okay, by the process called transformation. Okay. Okay. So the transformation may be achieved through, how can we achieve transformation? How can you do the transformation? So one way, infection with the transforming virus, such as polyoma virus. That means what you do, you just take the differentiated cell, okay, and then infect that cell with the polyoma virus. So polyoma virus is a virus that infects the mammalian cell and it makes the mammalian cell cancerous. So your cell, which is a normal cell, take out the normal cell, grow it in the in vitro, then that normal cell just put the virus. So virus will transform the cell and your cell will become cancerous cell and will go on dividing. Okay. Then second is the transfection with the mutant tumor causing gene. So transfection means addition of the DNA, okay, into a mammalian cell. That is called transfection. We have discussed earlier, transformation means entry of DNA into bacteria. That is called transformation. And an entry of DNA into a eukaryotic cell, it is called transfection. So transfection of a mutant tumor causing gene. So the tumors are caused because of the tumor causing genes. Okay. So in this case, what is done? In this case, so you have the normal cell. To this normal cell, okay, so this is the DNA that contains a gene for cancer. Okay, now this cancer causing gene, okay, it is inserted into, this cancer causing gene is, it is inserted into the normal cell, and thereafter this normal cell, it becomes cancerous. Normal cell becomes cancerous. Okay, so here this one is the DNA. Okay, so let me put it over here. So this DNA that contains the tumor genes or tumor causing genes, this tumor causing genes, okay, it is inserted into the normal cell. Okay, this insertion of the DNA into the normal cell, this process is called transfection. So transfection is simply
transformation, transfer
entry of DNA, entry of DNA into a mammalian cell. Transformation means entry of DNA into a bacterial cell. Transfection means entry of DNA into the mammalian cell. Okay, then what happens? This DNA enters and then this cell becomes cancerous. Okay. Okay. Then, so example is a RAS gene. So RAS gene, it is a tumor causing gene. Okay. Then exposure to the ionization radiation. Okay. So like UV rays. So another way is that what we can do is to just put the ionization radiation, that is the radiations which can cause cancer. So UV rays are responsible for causing cancer. So what is done, this normal cell, okay, is exposed to the UV rays. So when the normal cells are exposed to UV rays. Okay. So upon exposure to the UV rays, the normal cell becomes cancerous cell. Okay. The next way is the chemical carcinogens. So carcinogen means these are the chemicals that can generate cancer. Okay. So example is say pacritin dye. So this is a carcinogenic compound. Okay, so normal cells are, in this case, the normal cells are exposed to carcinogens such as pacritin dye. So in this case, what is going to happen when the normal cells are exposed to the pacritin dye or any other carcinogenic compound? So what happens? The normal cell becomes cancer. Okay. Then next is the somatic cell hybridization. Okay. So somatic cell hybridization means, in this case, what is done? Okay. We have a normal cell, okay. Fine. So the green color cell is the normal cell.
Normal cell.
Okay. Fine. And then we have the red color cells. So red color cell,
it's cancer cells.
It is a tumor cell. Okay. Or cancerous cell.
Cancerous cell.
Then what will happen when we fuse them? Okay. When you fuse these two cells.
Yes, sir.
So it makes a new cell type. Okay. So now this new cell type is a hybrid. Hybrid means it possesses the property of tumor cell as well as the normal cell. Okay. Now, since this new cell the property of a normal cell, okay, and can divide infinitely. Why? Because it has got a property of tumor cell also. Because tumor cells can divide infinitely. Okay. So now this type of cell, it has also got the capability of a tumor cell. So it will divide continuously. And it will be used as a continuous cell line. So this kind of cell, okay, this is called somatic cell hybrid. It's called
somatic cell hybrid.
Okay.
Yes, sir.
Okay. Epidoma. Okay. So effects of the transformation on a cell culture. So first is that infinite cell division capability. So the cell that has become transformed, okay, it will divide infinitely. In the normal cell, it divides 30 to 50 times only. But this cell, upon transformation, it will behave like a cancerous cell. It will divide indefinitely. Okay? Fine.
Yes,
then, aberrant cell growth control. Aberrant means, because normally what happens in case of differentiated cells, once the cells divide, okay, so after division, okay, there is a control that they cannot grow beyond 50 times. Okay. But these cells do not have any control. They will just go on dividing. Okay. That means there is no contact inhibition. Contact inhibition means once the cells. So contact inhibition means once the cells, they go on dividing. Okay.
Yeah.
Then the space is limited. They will stop dividing. Okay, normal cell. But cancerous cell, even if the space is limited, still they will go on dividing. Okay. That is called aberrant growth control.
Aberrant growth control. Okay, sir.
Then malignancy. Malignancy means these cells, they have the capability, okay, to show their cancerous property if they go to any kind of organ. If you just take the this continuous cell line and inject it to an individual, that individual will develop cancer. That is called malignancy. Okay?
Yes, sir.
Now we discuss about the media for the mammalian cell culture. So there are four basic criteria for the culture medium of cells, animal cells. Number one, nutritional requirement of the cell, because the different type of cells has got different nutritional requirement. If you take the skin cell, it has got different requirement. If you take a liver cell, it has got different requirement. Okay. So based on what type of cell it is, you should provide those nutrients into the medium, okay, where the cell will grow. Second is the pH. Okay. The pH should range from 7 to 7.3. Okay. This is the physiological pH. So most of the cells, they will grow optimally only when the pH is 7 to 7.3. Okay.
Yes, sir.
Then isotonic with the cell cytoplasm. Now, what is isotonic? So we have three terms here. So one is called
hypertonic.
Okay.
Hypotonic.
Then the second one is
isotonic.
Isotonic. and the third one is
hypotonic.
Hypertonic.
So it will be hypotonic.
Hypotonic. Okay. It will be hypotonic. Now hypertonic means in this case, what happens? You have a cell.
Yes,
okay.
Yes,
okay. Now the pressure or the concentration of the nutrients, if outside is less, suppose outside molecules are less and inside molecules are more. So you have high concentration of molecules inside the cell. Okay. Then outside. Okay. Then what will happen? The molecules always move from higher to lower concentration. So these molecules will go out. Okay. Fine. And apart from that, another point is that the water. Okay. Water always move from lower to higher concentration. This is to be remembered that water always move from lower to
higher concentration.
Higher
concentration.
Concentration. Okay. So what will happen in this case? The water present outside will go inside.
Go inside.
Okay.
Yes, sir.
And as a result, the cell will blast. Mm-hmm. Okay.
Yes,
now, what is hypotonic? So, in case of hypotonic, in this case, inside concentration is less. Okay. Outside concentration is high. So, then what will happen? The water will move out of the cell. Okay. So, in that case, what will happen? The cell will lose water. Okay, then what will happen? The cell will shrink. Okay, now what is isotonic here? So, isotonic means in this case, the number of molecules inside is equal to number of molecules outside. So, in that case, the water neither will enter nor it will exit. Okay, so the medium. Whichever we are using, it should be isotonic to the cell. Understood?
Yes, sir.
Okay. Then the next is the medium must be sterile.
Sterile.
Okay. Fine.
Yes,
so sterile. Sterile means it should
sterile
not have any contamination.
Any contamination.
Okay. That means it should not have a bacterial contamination because the medium. It easily gets the fungal contamination and all. So, it should be free from any kind of microbes. That is,
okay.
Medium should be sterile. Okay?
Okay, sir.
Now, the basic composition of the medium.
Okay.
So, basic composition is, it contains vitamins. Okay?
Yes,
it can, then, it should contain 5 to 10% fetal calf serum.
Yeah.
So fetal calf serum helps in adherence of the cells. So the cells will have to adhere to the glass or it has to adhere to the tissue culture bottle. Okay. So that adherence is helped by fetal calf serum. Then next is, it should have either HIPIS or sodium bicarbonate.
Carbonate.
So, HIPIS or sodium bicarbonate, what they do? They maintain the pH. Because we have seen that in case of tissue culture, the pH of the medium should be 7 to 7.3. So, this pH is maintained by this buffer. So, HIPIS or sodium bicarbonate, they act as a buffer. They maintain the pH. Okay?
Yes, sir.
Then they should have some antibiotics. So the medium should have some antibiotics so that it will prevent the growth of bacteria. The medium will remain sterile. Okay. So for to give the protection against the fungal infection, nystatin is used. Okay. and to give the protection against the mycoplasma infection. So mycoplasma is a bacteria, okay? To give the protection against mycoplasma, tetracycline, kanamycin, and gentamicin is used. Okay. Now the applications of the animal tissue culture. So it is used for, it is helpful for production of the monoclonal antibodies. Okay. So we'll discuss about it later on. Then it is helpful in cytotoxicity testing. That means cytotoxicity means cyto means cell. Toxicity means toxicity. Okay. Poisonous. So now there are some drugs, whether they are poisonous to us or not, this can be tested on the cell culture. You just put that drug in a cell culture, the cell dies. That means that compound is toxic. Okay. Then it is helpful in propagation of the virus. We can propagate the virus in the cell culture because the cell, the viruses cannot remain outside the cell. It has to remain inside the cell only. So that is why propagation of the viruses, it is done in a cell culture. Then studying the cytopathic effect. So cyto means cell, pathic means pathogenic. So the cell cultures are used to study the cytopathic effect of different bacteria or viruses. Okay, how the bacteria or viruses causes the pathological condition in the cells. This can be studied in the cell culture. Then it can be used for production of recombinant antibodies, recombinant proteins. So we have discussed that the recombinant proteins can be made in the bacteria, but same way the recombinant proteins can also be made in the cell culture. Okay, fine.
Okay.
So, do you have any question?
Sir, in case of that hypertonic, isotonic, and this hypotonic.
Yeah.
So, sir, my question is in hypertonic actually, sir. As you have said, like inside the cell, the number of molecules are more than the outside. But that water, that concentration, it goes from lower to higher than that water. How does it enter? Like the water will enter inside the cell or what, sir?
Okay. I would like to correct myself. So
okay,
in this case, you see, it should be
the number of molecules should go out.
Yeah, I'll tell you. It should be hypotonic.
Oh, it should be hypotonic, no?
And this should be
hypertonic.
Hypertonic. Okay. Let me tell you the things. Okay.
Okay, sir.
Now see, hypotonic means the medium has got less number of molecules as compared to the cell, inside cell. Okay. So now this medium, it is having the water. Water is present in both the cell as well as the medium. Okay. But in this, the statement says that the water always moves from lower to higher concentration. So outside the medium, concentration is less. So what will happen? The this water will move from outside to inside, lower to higher concentration.
Higher concentration.
Fine. In this case, the hypertonic means the medium has got higher number of molecules as compared to the cell. Okay. So what will happen? The water will move from inside to high, because inside concentration is less. Okay.
Less.
And outside it is more.
More.
So water will move from lower to higher concentration.
Higher. Oh.
So the cell will shrink. Okay.
Okay, sir.
So it should be isotonic. That means the concentration of molecules outside and inside should be equal.
Okay.
So that case, water will not move anywhere. Okay. Am I clear?
Okay. Sir. Yes, sir.
Okay.
Okay.
Okay. Fine. So, regarding the next class, I'll inform you by evening. Okay.
Okay. Okay, sir.
Okay.
Thank you, sir.